Hey guys, this is Martin again from Suzy. Welcome to part two of the setup of the ODE with Luminair. So what you want to do is you want to set up your ODE into the same range or exactly the same IP address of the router that you will be using. So in this case, we're going to set it up to the exact same. So that was, we go over here where the IP address modification can be done. And we're going to type that in 192.168.1. Oh, I did that wrong. All right. Sorry. 192.168.1.1. There we go. Okay. And then everything else we're pretty much going to leave the same since we're not doing a big setup or anything. So we don't need to change the subnet or the universe or anything like that. So we're going to click Save Config. And then it'll take a little while for it to update the settings on the ENTTEC ODE device. And while we wait for that, the next thing you want to do is be sure that your Wi-Fi router is on. Okay, so we got our power supply going, we got our lights on and all that, so we've got connection there. Next thing we're going to do, we're going to go on the iPad and we're going to find our router. So this is our router we're using right now. It comes up with this window because I don't have any internet going to it at the moment. Which is not needed whenever you're using Luminair. You don't need internet. We're just using a Wi-Fi signal, but you could make the setup work with internet. So either way, so we'll just click use without internet. And now you'll see that we're connected. Okay. So now that we know that we're connected for sure, we're going to set this aside. And then back here on the computer, it says success. All the settings have been changed successfully. So cool. We'll just close everything there. We're done there. Now we're going to disconnect the cable, the Ethernet cable from the computer, and we're going to connect it to one of the ports over here on the router. You're not going to go to the internet port where you actually connect the internet coming in, but we're going to go to these ports over here, the LAN ports, okay? So we're going to connect just like that. So you have a cable going from the ODE to the router, okay? And now we're going to connect our DMX cable from our DMX fixture over here to the output DMX of the ODE itself. So in this case, we're using a Cat5 to DMX. It could be, I mean, it'll vary from fixture to fixture, but this is where your DMX line goes. Okay, and in this instance, we're using a single unit. Okay, so we'll just kind of tidy this up here. Okay, and then make sure that your first unit is addressed to address 1, and that's what we got going on here. So it's dip switch 1, that's what we got. So okay, we've got connection from the iPad to the Wi-Fi router. Then we got the router connected physically with the Cat5 cable to the ODE. We got power to both, and we also have power to our DMX fixture over here. Next thing you wanna do, guys, is you're gonna open up your Luminair app, okay? And it'll look somewhat like this if you've never opened it before. It'll ask you to create a new project. So we're gonna click here, and then we'll click just in the center, and there we go. We've got a new project loaded, but as you can see, there's nothing really going on. Okay, so the first thing you want to do, you go to the bubble here, and what you want to do is enable ARNet. So you'll click there on the ARNet, and you click there, and it'll enable it. You usually set your node to broadcast, and everything else should be pretty much set. That's pretty much all there is to it. For most cases here, relating the setup of the Luminair. As you could see, this little bubble went from red to green. It means it's connected. We've got our connection up there. So now we're going to add a specific patch or a fixture, so to speak. So we'll go to color changer since we're using RGB. We'll select RGB, and then there you have it. We actually have control now. As you can see, this is a main fader, and this actually lights everything up just white, all three of them. But if we click here, it'll actually give us a little color wheel. This little color wheel looks black, but once you turn the main fader up, okay, the color wheel lights up. And then you could actually manipulate, change colors, and you could create presets. You'll see there's a little square there. You could click, hold it, and you could drag it, and you could create different presets of colors that you could jump to. So these are pretty much, you know, shortcuts that you could use to generate all these different presets. So you could select each one and quickly go from one preset to another. And then, I mean, there's different ways of doing it. You could also set up the actual layout of this with three different faders, one for each color if you don't want to do it like this. But there's just different ways of doing it. It's all going to depend on the fixture you're using, and it's also going to depend on your personal preference as far as using this. But remember, guys, that's pretty much all there is to it. As you can see, we've got our setup running here. We could just move the color wheel here and it'll change as we please. And remember, all you need is a router, your iPad or iPhone, your ODE, your DMX interface, I mean your DMX fixture over here, a Cat5 cable and a computer for the original setup. So, like I said, if you guys have any questions, comments, or concerns, please drop us a comment on the YouTube comment box. Also, don't forget to subscribe and check out our website at surge-e.com. Thanks for watching.